In this video, I will tell you about the Wallis team, a picture, a movie, and a book within the scope of the rural built environment lesson. First, we start with our picture. Painter Mehmet Emin Erşan, picture Winter in Anatolia. First of all, who is Mehmet Emin Erşan? He was born in Antalya. He graduated from Gazi University Education Faculty Painting Department. He started teaching in 1992. He founded the Eylül Art House in Kocaeli, continuing to work as a visual art teacher. The artist continues his painting studies in his own workshop in Antalya. Winter in Anatolia is harsh. Especially rural life is more difficult than urban life. There is a problem of the transportation and access to many things. Village roads are usually dirt. When it snows, the roads are closed to transportation to the village becomes difficult. If you look at the road where the carriages are going, you will see that the road is covered with snow. The village, which was buried in sloping land, consists of single-story houses. When you look at the color and texture of the paint, you will see that the foundation of the houses is painted different color, which may indicate the foundation above the ground. In such places, the foundation rises about 1.5 meters from the ground in order to protect the building floor from snow water in winter and prevent the wild reptile animals from entering the houses in summer. The windows of the houses are small and placed apart from each other. According to the color of the facade, the houses can be stone houses, can be covered with the earth plaster. Wooden planks were used on the roofs of the buildings. If you look at it carefully, you will see the wooden planks on the facade. Some roofs are sloping and some are flat. When we look at the facade of the houses with sloping roofs, we see animals. The increase is the likelihood of the buildings becoming barns. The close proximity of the barns houses is important in terms of the security and transportation in the village areas. Checked by the smoke coming out of chimney, the houses are heated with stoves. The only building with different architecture above the village is the mosque. Finally, the size, colors, shapes, location of the buildings in the village are so harmonious that the village as a whole looks great. Inspired by the village, this is painting successful emphasizes the village life in winter. Now, I will tell you about the movie called Kuduz, which tells about the village life. An Agas Wolfhard from Germany bites the children of the village, including the Aga's sons. Although the villager wants to kill the dog, the Aga does not accept that the dog has rabies and prevents it. Moreover, he doesn't want his own son to be vaccinated. This dispensary is quite far from village. The job taking the children of the dispensary falls to the lame young man, Tarık Akan, who falls in love with the Lord Bar's daughter, Necla Nazır. The film is about this process. This movie was shot in the village of the Osmani. The village, which was built at the foot of the mountain, is positioned in such a way that its houses do not each other view and also protect the privacy. The foundation of the houses were raised by stone walls about 1.5 meters high. The reason for that is to prevent the water from coming out of the floor of the house. Village people live in the local two-story wooden houses. The lower floor of the houses was used as a barn, and the upper floor was used as living space. The doors of the houses are positioned so that they do not see each other. In the village, one house is positioned with its back to the other. Roof houses are usually covered with sheet metal. The opening of the houses are small. Due to the climate condition, most of the houses have a makeshift verandas in front of them in summer. People spend time on the sofas placed on the verandas. Kıraathanes are made of makeshift wood. It's a small gathering place where the villagers come and spend time, as well as place to receive news. In the village, the radio available only in the Kıraathane and Aga's house. The Aga is considered superior to the people in terms of the status. He can have a say in the village because he has a sufficient financial power. The difference in status in the village can be understood from the house where the people live. For example, the Aga house has two floors. The facade of the house is painted and well maintained. Its veranda is wider and its sofa better quality. As a result, the architecture in the villagers reveals the socio-economic status of the villagers. Finally, I will talk about Orhan Hançerlioğlu works called Karanlık Dünyaya Ekilmemiş Topraklar, which is about the village life. He was born 19 August 1916 in Istanbul. He died on 9 July 1991 in Istanbul. He is now known for dictionary studies in the fields of philosophy and economics. He graduated from Şişli Terakki High School. He graduated from Istanbul University Faculty of Law in 1939. He worked as district governor in Meriç, Keşanlı and Karaysalı. Hançerlioğlu, who had the opportunity to examine the village-city relationship very well during his duty as the district governor, retired in 1978. Orhan Hançerlioğlu started literature with the poetry. As for the subject of the book, it is a book about the fate and poverty of the Anatolia from the Ottoman Empire to the Republic. There are many findings that highlighted the creativity of the Turkish villagers and their different ways of the thinking from those of the city dwellers. According to the author, it is a natural condition and tradition that determine the character of the villager. Urbanized act in the certain social order. The villager, on the other hand, has a structure that struggles in his own unique world and does not give in to all kinds of difficulties and troubles. It is to reveal the characteristic behavior patterns developed by Turkish people while continuing their struggles for life in the city and in the village, throughout the possibility of the functional structure. The idea of organization social to ensure people's happiness begins with the commitment to the land. They compete with the nature, not with each other. Orhan Hançerlioğlu books deals with the discussed very different behavior patterns, perspectives and mental structure arising from the human nature, human-human conflict. The broad spectrum of the peasant and citizen, especially the problem arising from the peasant-urban separation on the social scale, the cunning of the peasant based on the practical intelligence, the humiliation and marginalization of the peasant and citizen, poverty and backwardness. What happened is a result of the villagers not being able to benefit education, healthy economy and development services as much as urban people. At the same time, green texture of the cities has disappeared with the unplanned urbanization. Air pollution and visual pollution have emerged due to the works that are devoid of the aesthetics and factories roads that have been boiled. The situation negatively affected the lower class living in the poverty and misery psychologically. Village life is better for psychology than the city life. Since the village houses located in the nature are built with the natural materials, people do not have the places they live. The fact that each village house has a large gardens and is a connect with the soil, good for human psychology. As a result, it has been a book emphasizing how structural affects human psychology.